Stan, all your life, you have been a big advocate for immigration and respect for immigrants. Your parents were immigrants. You were an immigrant. You came to the U.S. from South Africa. So what's been your reaction to President Trump's immigration policies recently?
So, Susie, it's really about business. And the bottom line is business needs immigrants. So if you look at the high-tech area, there's a shortage of people in that area. Programmers, people to drive the computer economy. We need immigration. So it's not about whether it's the right thing to do or the wrong thing to do. It's about not about politics. It's about business.
I'm sure you've seen the comments coming from CEOs from Apple and Cisco and Microsoft who have been speaking publicly and very passionately on this issue. What about you? What have you decided to do? Are you going to take a stand on this?
Well, we've always been a proponent of immigration. In fact, if we don't have immigration, it results in jobs moving offshore. I think it is critical that we allow qualified people to immigrate to the United States. In fact, we train them in our universities, and then a year later we tell them, leave the country. We'll give you a visa for 2 years. That'll make economic sense.
You've always said that Henry Schein's secret sauce is the company's devotion to social responsibility. Immigration is just one of those issues. There are so many other controversial issues that Americans face every single day. How do you as a CEO decide which issues you're going to speak out on and which ones you're not?
Well, what is important is to align the interests with society. And it does make economic sense to allow immigrants into this country. It does make economic sense to treat all people equal, to treat diversity as a critical component of public policy. And that's been the basis of Henry Schein's philanthropy, the Henry Schein's alignment on access to oral care and other kinds of health care. We want to do what's right for the economy, right for the people of this country, and access to care and immigration, for example, are very much important for the success of the American people.
And you're not uncomfortable talking about these issues as the CEO. You're not worried about any kind of negative reaction if you speak up.
I think what is very important for CEOs is to remain bipartisan. But we should stand out and stand up for issues such as civility. We need civility in the workplace, in society, and we should ensure that every single American is treated equal, regardless of their background. And those are issues. When those issues become a concern, I don't think it's a partisan issue. It becomes bipartisan, and CEOs have an obligation to talk out.
What happens if there's a conflict or a trade-off between one of these social responsibility issues and profits? How do you deal with that?
I've never been questioned by a shareholder as to our commitment to corporate social responsibility. It's worked for Henry Schein. We have a higher ambition than simply to make money, and at the end of the day, our return on investment has been pretty good.
You've been CEO of Henry Schein for 30 years, and that's a long time, and I'm sure you remember that there was a time when CEOs stayed out of the spotlight on a lot of these politicized issues.
Yes.
They prefer to stay silent or, at best, neutral. Yes. What's changed? Why is it okay now to speak up on all these issues?
Well, when I became CEO 29 years ago, the notion of businesses aligning interests with society from a social point of view was something that was rather foreign. Things have changed gradually over the years. And in fact, now, I think the millennials are driving change. They're asking a lot of questions. And since the millennials today are becoming a key component of the consumer dollars being spent by society, millennials are asking a lot of questions. And this is causing CEOs and businesses in general to question themselves and aligning more and more with the needs of society.